Hello, welcome back to Module 5, Part 3 of our ITL&D Naked Course for PowerShell. So far, what we have covered, 1, 2, 3, and 4, which is Introduction, Getting Started, Overview and Object, Pipeline and Formatting, and we started with Data Structure. And we did Module 1, or Part 1 and Part 2, and today we will do Part 3, which is a bit longer than the previous two. And then later on we'll do scripting, functions, and then AD, Exchange, SQL. Quick recap to what we'll be covering under part of module 5. With the three parts, the focus will be around writing and formatting output. And these are the area topics which we will be covering. And we start with formatting, output, write, string. And for today, we will be covering, the inheritance around our object. So the definition made on system object class are very relevant for PowerShell writing. The whole formatting system would not work if you don't use format star. Also, get member would not work. The equal method is used to compare object, which is hyphen equal operator, sort object, where object, and as you can see there, the two strings get hash code, get type equal, system.object will give me a value type or Marshall by reference object that include the system, Intel 32, boolean, and process. And as you can see, full name, extension, and then we move towards the two strings and get directories. Let's have a look at this in more detail. Now, hair string. A hair string is started by the add sample or add with a comma. The hair string is used to embed large chunk of text in line in a script. This can be powerful when you generate output for another program. When hair string is displayed, it contains all of the lines that were entered. Hair string have special cutting rules, and such cuts as sub-expression are both fine hair. This include both single cuts and double cuts. Hair string start with the double or single and a character chain. The content is then started on the new line and contained until it's ended with the double at or single at character chain, as you can see on that example below. Now, the content of the hair string is all of the line between the beginning and the ending cut, but not the lines the cut are on. Because of the fancy opening and closing cut sequence, other special characters such as cuts that would cause a problem in regular string are fine here. This make it easy to generate string data without having cutting error. Here is more elaborating example. Next, escape characters are used to assign special interpretation to a character that follow. In Windows PowerShell, the escape character is the bracket, or it's a back tick, also called grave accent, which is ACCI 96. The escape character can be used to indicate a literal, to indicate line continuation, and to indicate special character. You can see the description under the wiki. An escape character is a character which invoke an alternate interpretation on subsequent character in a character sequence. It can enable or disable the next character and alternate interpretation of it. Now, let me just describe these three before we move on to the next. The indicating literal. When an escape character precedes a variable, it prevents the value from being substituted for the variable. When an escape character precedes a double quotation mark, Windows PowerShell interprets the double quotation mark as a character, not as a string delimiter, indicating line continuation. The escape character tells Windows PowerShell that the command continue to the next line, indicating the last part special character. When used with the quotation marks, the escape character indicates a special character that provides instructions to the command parsers. Let's have a look at the escape character. Special character like line feeds are easy to use in PowerShell. You can see the 0, A, B, C, F, N, R, T, V, either null, alert, backspace, form, feed, new line, carriage, return, horizontal tab, vertical tab, literal, quote. Now, let me just describe each one of these. Null, Windows PowerShell, recognize null special character, 0, and represent it with the character code of the 0 equivalent, it or the shape. It appears as an empty space in the Windows PowerShell output. Alert, which is A, the alert, A character send a beep signal to the computer speaker. You can use to warn user about a impending action. Backspace, character move the cursor back to the character. The output, and same thing for the from feed. The form feed character F is a print instruction that eject the current page and continue printing to the next page. New line characters is a break immediately, and it does give us the output. Character return. It's the character R, eliminate the entry or the entire line prior to the R character. And the horizontal tab character, advance to the next tab, stop and continue writing. And the last part, which is the vertical. The horizontal tab character T, advance to the next vertical. And the character affect the printing. Next is the script blocking. Script block is a piece of script code surrounded by the curly bracket. Script blocks are used extensively in PowerShell statements, but they can exist in their own right, anonymous unnamed object reference. Other program languages have used the same idea as a script block in the past and refer to them as a lambda or lambda functions. Script blocks are in fact metaprogramming. I do have some sample for us here, which we can be utilized to be tested as well later on when you have time. Again, script blocks equal metaprogramming. Script blocks are extensively used when you are using object with for each object or statements. They are indicating by curly brackets. You can see that the example below to calculate the size of a file, and every time where object or for each object used, secret block are utilized as well. That was a basic example, get having child item for each object being with calculating the file size, and that will write the sum and the output for me. More on the script block. Script block can be executed directly. Script block that should handle pipeline output need to implement a process and can return data and take arguments. The call operator execute script block. Again, I've got another sample script for us to be tested now. The definition of the script block looks like just definition of a function, except the function name are omitted. If the parameters bracket statement is not present in the script block, will receive argument through the $argument variable. Note that switch as well as name parameter can be placed in the parameter statement. A switch parameter is a boolean value, which is $true if present or false if it's omitted, that can check if have been passed using if statement or switches or do nothing. You can see the touch code. It's an example for a script block structure. You can use it to check the component of beginning and must, you know, process component which execute it to pass pipelines. The example will list all the process objects using the get-process command and will pass it as a script block for us. Will help us understand how the script block works. That's all what I had for you for today for this part 3. Let's just recap what we have covered. Again, we started with module 5 part 3, spoke about inheritance, and then we moved toward the hair strings. We spoke about hair strings, how to start, format with code, double code, and then we moved toward escape characters. We covered escape characters and some of the, you know, characters and parameters were that special, like the nil, alert, horizontal or vertical tabs, and the literal code. And then the last part we covered was the script block, and we said script block is equal to the meta programming, and we said script block always, you know, end up as a statement with segment and can be executed even directly. And then we show some other sample scripts which attach, which you can use to display like a process as a script block. That's all what I had for today. Hopefully you have learned something useful, and I shall see you at part 5 or module 5 part 4. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.